WWE.
Well, we remember what happened the last time the chamber match took place at Survivor Series.
It was brutal, to say the least.
Weighing 282 pounds, Test!
Well, we've got a lot to get to this week here on Heat Beat. We got to talk about it right off the top of the show. What a night Eric Bischoff had last Monday on Raw.
Well, Coach, with the way the night started out, I know that that was the last thing, a banner night for Mr. Bischoff, anybody was going to expect to happen.
And we're going to show everybody exactly what you're talking about and some great action right here tonight on Sunday Night Heat. Stick around. We're going to have a lot of fun. And speaking of having fun and
yes,
being funny,
uh-huh,
nice hair this week.
Oh, thank you. I just watched it. I can't do a thing with it.
From the Yonkers, New York, weighing 252 pounds, Tommy Dreamer.
Well, like I was saying about the chamber match at Survivor Series, you know what happened there? It wasn't just brutal, it was a title change.
Certainly, and Triple H, if he wasn't, I won't say he was at a disadvantage before facing Goldberg, but now that Triple H has that injured groin out, and Triple H now has to face five other men inside that elimination chamber, thinking about licking their chops, Jericho, Randy Orton, Kevin Nash, Shawn Michaels, and Goldberg and Triple H, any one of those six men to walk out of SummerSlam, the new World Heavyweight Champion.
But you've got to give the nod to Jericho, you've got to give the nod to Shawn Michaels, and you've got to give the nod to
Triple H.
That's right, because they've all been in a chamber match before.
Very, very good point. Here we go. Great match to kick things off here on Heat. Test going one-on-one with Tommy Dreamer. And doesn't it seem to you, Al, that each and every week, Test gets, if it's possible, gets more and more cocky?
I don't think it's cocky. I think he's eaten up with jealousy over Steiner and Stacy.
Oh, big shoulder block.
See, he's copying Scott Steiner.
Certainly is doing that. I would agree with you, Al, that Tess is still consumed with the jealousy of losing his girlfriend and former manager, Stacy Keibler. Quite frankly, I think I would be too.
Yeah, and he even went out and cost Steiner the match last week on Raw against Randy Orton. So it's still like he just can't get over it. It's much like yourself. You know how they had to put that restraining order on you. I told you, I've learned myself that you can't make somebody love you. You can just stalk them and hope to wear them down.
Nobody home. Tommy Dreamer gets out of the way.
Russian leg sweep.
A beautiful counter. Now Tommy Dreamer right back up to his feet.
The innovator of violence.
You know, these two men, you can say they're evenly matched in the ring. You can see the intensity on the face. Pain is Tommy Dreamer's middle name.
Baseball slide.
But Al, they come from such two different worlds, Test and Tommy Dreamer.
That's right, Test like a bodyguard for, what was the band?
I think it was Motley Crue
that. One of those hair bands that you like so much.
You know I don't like them.
You love them.
I like the boy bands.
Yeah, that's true.
Because they have the hot chicks.
Yeah, O-Town.
I don't like O-Town.
You do too.
I just hung out with them one night. That was it.
Couldn't peel you away from the TV on making the band.
Now Tommy Dreamer attacking that left shoulder, continuing, just wrenching that left shoulder of Test.
That didn't work. Test held his ground.
Oh, beautiful.
Sidewalk slam.
Beautiful sidewalk slam by Test.
Test so strong.
I'm actually a Backstreet Boys fan.
Are you?
Now Tommy Dreamer is down and Test taking the opportunity to pose, to let the crowd know how much he appreciates himself.
I thought that, you're a big fan of Justin Timberlake.
I do. Well,
since you have him all over your room.
Well, he's dating Cameron Diaz, and that's cool.
And he was dating Britney Spears,
and
too.
And that's even cooler. Alyssa Milano, some guys have all the luck. I mean, you know, we've all had some hot chicks, Al, but that's going above and beyond. Speaking of above and beyond, these two men continue just to beat on each other and Test. You know, say what you want about Test. This guy, when he's inside the ring, and you've talked about it a lot, Al, continues to get better and better.
Oh, without a doubt. He is, look, again, mocking Steiner, but he has stepped it up. Ever since he dropped Stacy, I think it's the best thing he could do for his career. He has become so intense and so driven in that ring. Look at the force on that slam.
Speaking of intense, speaking of driven, a little bit later on, we're going to take you back to Raw and show you the entire night of what went down between Eric Bischoff, Shane McMahon, Kane, Evolution. It was a tremendous night. And who knows what's going to happen tomorrow night. We're going to be live from the Mark of the Quad Cities in Moline, Illinois.
And like we said at the beginning of the show, it was a tremendous night for Eric Bischoff, which was a big shock to everyone the way it started out.
You're exactly right. We'll get to that a little bit later on right here on Heat. But now Tommy Dreamer imploring himself to get back to his feet and a couple of big shots to the midsection. midsection, but shut down just like that by Test.
Test is so physical. He needs to quit strutting around. He's wasting too much time. You can't do that with Tommy Dreamer.
You cannot do that. You're exactly right with a superstar the caliber of Tommy Dreamer.
Big slam off the top rope.
Well, as you alluded to, Test taking too much time. Tommy Dreamer gets back to his feet, and now Tommy Dreamer trying to buy a little bit of time so he can restore that energy that he's lost here in this match.
See, that gave him the time to regroup, kind of get his breath, get his thoughts back together.
And now both men back to their feet. Tommy Dreamer counters, big shots. Dreamer ducks under, big clothesline.
Dreamer getting fired up.
Well, Test.
Ducks a clothesline again, neckbreaker.
Oh, and now Tommy Dreamer rolls over on Test. This would be a huge win for Dreamer, too. And nearly a pinfall on Test, and all this strutting around, all this cockiness, all this bragging nearly came back to haunt Test in just a matter of seconds.
Pump handle, this could be it.
Oh,
taking too much time.
Setting up for the pump handle slam. He's got Dreamer up, but a nice counter. Dreamer
able to close line. Up.
Oh, what a
way backdrop.
And this could be enough. Oh, but oh, unable to get those shoulders locked down. And Test, again, just at the last moment, Al, able to get that shoulder up.
Man, how's Test doing it? Tommy Dreamer, what's he doing?
Oh, Tommy Dreamer's got that kendo stick.
When all else fails, stick him! Put some stank on it, Tommy.
Oh, but the referee grabs that kendo stick. Oh, now, a big shot to the midsection. Now going for the DDT.
Yep, goes for the pump handle.
And again, oh, he's got him up this time.
This is it.
Nails it perfectly. This one is over. You can put this one.
Oh, he kicked out. Look at Test.
Test cannot believe that Tommy Dreamer was able to kick out.
I can't believe it. The crowd can't believe it. I know you can't believe it either. Big boot. No.
Oh, Tommy Dreamer runs out of the way, and now
Test is on the top rope.
Oh.
You can feel this one at home, and
DDT.
Oh.
This is it. It's got to be.
Tommy Dreamer, the upset over Test.
Man.
This one continues to go back and forth, back and forth.
Tommy going to the top rope, not exactly home up there.
Yeah, what in the world would Tommy Dreamer need in the high rent district?
Oh, Test kicked the referee into the ropes, knocked Tommy down on the top rope.
Quite frankly, I don't know what Tommy Dreamer was going to do from up there, but it would have been interesting to watch.
Well, now Test again taking a little too much time.
Test still very, very proud of himself. Now going to that middle rope out. This is a very, very dangerous spot for both men to be in.
Tommy fighting back. What's he gonna do?
Oh, I don't know. Right. Oh! Tommy Dreamer jumps right into that big boot by Test.
Two,
and that
three.
May be enough. And what a battle. Test escapes.
Here is your winner, Test.
Wow.
Test, so intense, so physical. Let's see that big boot again. Look at this. Puts a little stank on.
Well, you mentioned it, Al. Tommy Dreamer not exactly at home.
Well, he was on the map there.
Well, folks, still to come tonight here on Heat, it's mixed tag action. The Maze has teamed up with Ivory to take on Steven Richards and Victoria.
But up next.
Absolutely. The Puerto Rican girl and the Mexican girl, they're perfect. Great. Send them to my... You know what? I'll call you right back. Miss Jackie, could you please come back down here just for a couple of seconds?
Just a couple.
You and I need to have a little talk here. Now, as you know, Venus Video Productions is ready to debut. Mm-hmm. And you, Miss Jackie, you have exactly what it takes to quite possibly become the greatest Venus Video Platinum chick of all time.
Of all time?
Of all time.
Oh, okay.
First things first, I'm gonna need to take some test shots of you, if you don't mind.
Right now?
Now is as good a time as any.
Here?
Right here. Come on. Hop up on here. Oh, yeah, just like that. Put one hand here. Put your legs up over here, just like
that. About like that. That work?
Absolutely. Bring your chin up a little bit. A little bit of a smile. Oh, yeah, that's what I'm talking about. You know something? There's one thing missing. Hold up right there. Don't move. This is what you need. Hold on to that right there. Right there. Don't move. Something? There's just two other things missing. Don't move. Right back. This will finalize this picture and make it exactly what I've been looking for.
You're right, Val. This is very appealing.
That's twice, Rico. Twice.
You know, good things always come in threes.
Now, what a great moment for the Heartbreak Kid at WrestleMania 12. And now, 7 years later, Shawn Michaels has a chance to capture the gold in the Elimination Chamber at SummerSlam.
Introducing first, at a combined weight of 533 pounds, Mark Jindrak and Garrison Keene.
Well, let's not forget, Coach, he's already won the WWE Gold once before at Survivor Series in that same match, the Elimination Chamber match, when they first held it.
And Shawn Michaels barely survived that night, and Triple H's career was almost ended. You remember, Triple H had to be rushed to the hospital after a crushed trachea.
Yes, after Rob Van Dam came off the top of the cage.
And Triple H heads into this Elimination Chamber again, not 100% with that injured groin. And you have to believe if ever there was a time that Triple H was going to lose the World Heavyweight Championship, it would be in Phoenix at SummerSlam.
Well, most would believe that, that's for sure. But Triple H has had a way of pulling the fat out of the fire, so to speak. And if anybody can appreciate what Triple H is going through right now with that groin injury, it'd be you, because you live with a substandard groin all the time.
Well, here we go, Mark Jindrak and Garrison Cade, this fine young new tag team taking on Tony Kazina and Buddy Wayne.
And Buddy Wayne just ran in and bounced like a rubber ball off of the back of Mark Jindrak.
The Garrison Cade and Mark Jindrak, Al, a couple of weeks ago, defeating La Resistance right here on Heat in a non-title matchup. So certainly these two youngsters who have the look, have the charisma, have the potential, you know, can get the job done on the right night.
That is true. They got a ton of potential. They just see if the inexperience trips them up or not.
And speaking of La Resistance, the Dudley boys got a little major revenge last Monday night on Raw as Bubba Ray was able to defeat Rene Dupree in a one-on-one contest. The Dudley boys are dying, Al, to get back those tag team titles.
That's true. And 2 weeks ago on Raw, the Dudleys came to Cade and Jindrak's help when La Resistance was beaten on him after the match.
Oh, and now a shot to the back, and Mark Jindrak almost just a gnat to the back of this huge new athlete here. But just like that, a beautiful tag team maneuver.
More than one
cover,
get a cat.
Well, you're exactly right.
Pin him. That's where you win the match, okay?
Why wouldn't you pin him there? Obviously, they're giving up a lot of size.
Right.
You know, they're giving up a lot of skill. But when you make a move like that, you got to jump on top and maybe steal one.
You got to make it count. You got to make it count. That could be a very costly mistake. Now he's where? On the mat. Where do you win a match? On the mat. Pin him. But I think that these guys, they get a little, you know, intimidated, of course, obviously by the size, but also that they're in a WWE ring and against a WWE superstar, and so they're out there trying to really overcompensate sometimes. Beautiful doubles flying tackle. But now, there you go.
Here's a cover, no hook of the leg. Oh, and a big-time kick out by Mark Jindrak, who is so strong and so big. And Mark Jindrak desperately needs a tag right now. I never thought I would say that. And Garrison Cade on the outside, all he can do is watch.
Yeah, you never thought you'd hear those words coming out of your mouth on this match, did you?
Well, now both of these men, Tony Kazina and Buddy Wayne, a little bit more impressive than I think even we thought here tonight on Heat. Speaking of tag teams still to come here tonight, Steven Richards teams up with Victoria, that wacky twosome, to take on Maven and Ivory.
Wacky. Kooky.
Well, I don't know what you're laughing
trippy
at, because the last few weeks, you and Steven Richards have become very tight, trying to save your job and trying to bury me in the process.
Hold on. We haven't become anything. I've just been walking around. Next thing I know, it's Al Stone, which my name is Al Snow. And then he proceeds to give me Stevie Knight exclusives. I don't want them.
You just happen to get them.
Right. Oh, man. Oh. Look at the beautiful top rope springboard double clothesline. Not just a beautiful move that Mark Jindrak just pulled off.
I prefer to say beautiful move. It sounds better. Oh,
here comes Lance
Cade. In comes Garrison Cade.
Garrison, I tell you, he's a throwback to Barry Windham. I'm sure that was a little before your time.
I used to be a big Barry Windham fan.
A big one?
A big one.
Big one. You used to love the Bradys, too.
I did like the Bradys.
Yeah.
So we brought up O-Town, Backstreet Boys, and the Bradys all in one Sunday night heat.
My favorite Brady was Greg. Yours was Peter. Yeah. Peter. That's all you talked about.
You talk about a throwback to Barry Windham. Oh, look at the leg and break up of the three count. That left.
The Charles Manson lookalike now doing slam.
Now all four men in the ring, and Garrison Cade and Mark Jindrak. Oh! What elevation on the drop kick. Both of these men, Al, have tremendous drop kicks.
Tremendous athletic ability.
Here are your winners, Mark Jindrak and Garrison Cade.
Well, big win for Garrison Cade and Mark Jindrak. And Al, it's been a busy couple of weeks for the Raw Superstars. They recently went down under in Australia. Let's take a look at the great time they had last week on the Ruthless Aggression Tour.
Ahead live from Phoenix.
Oh, I can't wait for them. Coming up next year on Heat, Steven Richards and Victoria go face to face with Maven and Ivory. That's next here on Heat.
Here he comes. Here comes the boy. That's what I'm talking about.
The following mixed tag team match is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first from Charlottesville, Virginia, Maven.
Maven, WWE superstar, got the world by the short hairs.
The real short hair.
Oh, yeah. Well, his eyebrows ain't short. You know, if he ever doesn't want to be bald, all he has to do is comb those eyebrows back. Here she comes. Look at
his tag team partner, Ivory.
Always with a lot to say, Ivory, Maven's tag team partner this week here on Heat, and I can tell you that Stacker 2's YJ Stinger presents WWE SummerSlam. SummerSlam is going to come to you live Sunday, August 24th from Phoenix, Arizona, exclusively on pay-per-view. Stacker 2's YJ Stinger for that extreme boost of energy. You've got to feel the sting.
I don't know. I'm a little allergic to bee stings.
I think you're allergic to a lot of things.
You'll see.
Here comes the boss.
See, that's what I'm talking about.
The team of Steven Richards and Victoria.
You continue to kiss his butt week in and week out. Here comes the boss. Here comes the boss of Stevie Knight Heat.
Whoa. I'm not kissing anybody's butt. No way. But you've got to kind of like humor the insane.
Which is what I try to do each and every week with you.
You know what? I'm not crazy anymore. I don't talk to the head anymore. Of course, I talk to something worse. You!
Well, Al, I do need to give everybody out there an update on the condition of Shane McMahon. We saw just a few moments ago what Kane did to Shane McMahon, the tombstone into those steel steps. And Shane suffered a stinger and a concussion.
And he's lucky that that was all he suffered.
Wow, I could not, well, I shouldn't say I couldn't believe it, because we've seen Kane attack Linda McMahon.
He said, JR on fire.
Eric Bischoff, and now Shane McMahon. Will this ever end with the big red monster, RVD?
I hope not until he gets his hands on you.
Well, here we go. I'll ignore that, too. Maven and Steven Richards. This is a mixed tag match. Excuse me.
Wow, Ivory throwing some rough right hands into the boss. Ooh, there's kissing butt.
I think Steven Richards may have actually enjoyed that one. But Ivory, who's been shopping at Steven Richards.
Keep this up. He's going to fire you. I'm telling you.
Well, that wouldn't be the worst thing. What in the wide world?
Okay.
I think Steven Richards just realized what was going on. And
wow. Victoria, that might have hurt if there was something up there to knock around.
No, Maven and Ivory working very, very well together here early on.
Maven works really well with women all the time.
Hey, Al, I got to ask you real quick. That challenge that was made earlier on Raw this week by Chris Jericho. Oh, the huge Stevie kick, and Maven goes through the ropes and down to the floor.
Right in the teeth and all the way to the floor.
What about that hair versus hair challenge by Chris Jericho?
Wow.
Will it be accepted? If it is, when will it happen?
I don't have good hair, but the last thing I want to do is have it cut and look like you. I know that neither Chris Jericho or Kevin Nash would ever want that. And I know, hey, I'd love to see that accepted by either one of them.
Well, both men, we know how.
Oh! Maybe it'll happen tomorrow night on Raw.
A wonderful flipping out. Steven Richards falls up with a cover. Maven gets that left shoulder up just before the count of three. It may happen tomorrow night on Raw. We have no idea. Kevin Nash, at this point, has yet to accept this stipulation or this match for that matter.
What's the boss, Stevie Richards, doing? He's got the hat on. I'll show you. Well, that cost him.
Taking too much time. Nobody home. Maven gets out of the way. Stephen Richards nails himself, Victoria, taking it upon herself to go in and take care of Maven.
And that backfired.
Modified backdrop by Maven. Here comes a tag, and here comes Ivory going up top.
Well, she's hot, and she's crazy, and a crossbody on both.
A double crossbody by Ivory, who was on fire, and that taking out her frustrations on Victoria.
And aren't all women frustrated?
Well, one way or the other. Big elbow by Ivory. Oh, nice neckbreaker. And here comes a cover. Will this be a victory for Ivory and Maven?
No.
And Stephen Richards breaks up the three count.
The boss breaking up the count. And in comes Maven. Hey, don't touch my girl.
And now all four competitors in the ring and getting after it. Referee Charles Robinson cannot get any order in his face.
Plastic surgery needed.
I'm begging for a count.
Get out of the ring, Maven.
Four, five, six by Ivory.
Oh, here comes the boss.
Referee Charles Robinson.
Stevie T. Oh, my gosh.
The Stevie T on Ivory by Stephen Richards. And Charles Robinson didn't even see it.
Whoa.
And that's it.
Guess when you're the boss, you can make your own rules.
Stephen Richards and Victoria.
Wow. Can't wait for tomorrow night. We'll be live on Raw in Moline, Illinois. The mark of the Quad Cities. What will Kane do? What will Eric Bischoff do?
What will Kevin Nash do? Will Shane be there?
Well, you got to wonder. It's going to be a big night. We're just 2 weeks away from SummerSlam. For Al Snow, I'm the coach. We'll see you tomorrow night.
Adios.